Hello everyone, I thought I would update real quickly the Acanthoscurria Chacoana. She got a rehouse after her molt. Said in a previous video that I was going to rehouse her, and I decided to put her in something a little bigger. And completely automated myself with the bark and everything. She wasn't really happy when she got in here. She was attacking the paintbrush, but that's my fault because I should have actually fed her before I moved her, and then maybe fed her then moved her a couple days later. But she was really cramped in the last enclosure, and I believe she wanted a bigger enclosure. So this is the old Avic Metallica's enclosure. It was an arboreal setup. I took out the glued down cork bark, flipped it back for a terrestrial enclosure, and now this Acanthoscurria is, the Chacoana is going to be in here for a while, at least for a couple of molts, and then I move her in something a little bigger, depending on her size. She's been doing well after her molt. She eats very well. Definitely don't want those fangs dug into you. Otherwise, she's a very sweet and docile tarantula. She doesn't really show any aggressive tendencies, only when she's very hungry, and I haven't fed her in a while. So, she's probably not too happy. She's an awesome tea. Definitely recommend getting one of these if you can. If you can find one, but they're really not too hard to find. I thought they were more rare than they actually are. They're really not that rare. You just have to find the right place to get them. What's rare is getting them anything over a couple of inches. You have to get them small, but they grow fast. She was about an inch when I got her, and she's close to 3 inches now, and she's only had a couple molts since I've had her in my care. She's loving this enclosure so far. What I did was it was one big piece of bark that I split in three pieces, and I glued those together. It has moss on the other side. And then I put it in there, put the substrate down, and then I took another piece of cork bark, split it in half, glued it together. And then I glued the edge of the corner there to make almost like a little tunnel. And that's what you see in there. And it works perfectly for her. I like this kind of setup better. It looks a little more natural than the thick cork bark. And I do recommend going and getting tree bark, because you can see that it's very thin. So it takes up a little room, especially if you put it in there right. And you actually get more of a natural environment that does not take up much space, especially with the thinner bark. You just have to be careful to make sure you go through each one of these pieces and break off the more jagged pieces. And they do fine in there. So yeah, I thought I'd update her real quick. And I'll be featuring her in an upcoming video. A lot of people have been asking me to do a feeding video to kind of show how I do it, and it takes me a while to go through all my teas, because I usually do the enclosures, maintenance in there, water them, and feed them all at the same time, so I'm not doing it multiple times a week. But if I do get a chance to feature get a feeding video in, I'll make sure she's in there. She's an aggressive eater, and she has some really nice attacks. Yeah, she's awesome. Alright guys, thanks for watching.